foreign soldiers or alien bureaucrats, however well motivated and disciplined, are in the long run the most reliable guardians I got agreed to. The United States favors the early establishment of a provisional government for Germany. Progress has been made in the American zone in developing local and state self-government in Germany. And the American government believes that similar progress is possible in all zones. And then submitted to the German people for ratification. While we shall insist that Germany observe the principles of peace, good neighborliness, and humanity, we do not want Germany to become the satellite of any power or powers, or to live under a dictatorship, foreign or domestic. The American people hope to see a peaceful and democratic Germany become and remain free and independent. Time has also come to define the boundaries of the new Germany. The United States does not feel that it can deny to France, which has been invaded 3 times by Germany within 70 years, its claim to the Saar territory, whose economy has long been closely linked with France. Of course, if the Saar territory is integrated with France, she should readjust her reparation claims against Germany. Our acceptors here indicated the United States will not support any encroachment on territory which is indisputably German, or any division of Germany which is not genuinely desired by the people concerned. So far as the United States is aware, the people of the Ruhr and the Rhineland desire to remain united with the rest of Germany, and the United States is not going to oppose their desire. While the people of the Ruhr were the last to succumb to Nazism, without the resources of the Ruhr, Nazism could never have threatened the world. Never again must those resources be used for destructive purposes. They must be used to rebuild a free and peaceful Germany and a free and peaceful Europe. The United States will favor such controls over the whole of Germany, including the Ruhr and Rhineland, as may be necessary for security purposes. It will help to enforce those controls, but it will not favor any controls that would subject the Ruhr and Rhineland to political domination or the manipulation of outside powers. The German people are now feeling the devastating effects of the war which Hitler and his minions brought upon the world. Other people felt those devastating effects long before they were brought home to the people of Germany. The German people must realize that it was Hitler and his minions who tortured and exterminated innocent men, women, and children, and sought with German arms to dominate and degrade the world. It was the massed, angered forces of humanity which had to fight their way into Germany to give the world the hope of freedom and peace. It has returned to Germany practically all prisoners of war that were in the United States. We are taking prompt steps to return German prisoners of war in our custody in other parts of the world. The United States cannot relieve Germany from the hardships inflicted upon her by the war her leaders started. But the United States has no desire to increase those hardships or to deny the German people an opportunity to work their way out of those hardships, so long as they respect human freedom and follow the paths of peace. The American people want to return the government of Germany to the people of Germany. The American people want to help the German people to win their way back to an honorable place among the free and peace-loving nations of the world.